PRE.
Kay JP o kay Renjo, it is a viable
kita naman natin kanina eh. Game 1. Ang ganda ng pagkakaya free hit at crit. Yung damage output talaga neto ni Granger all throughout. So, syempre, you would know. You don't want to give that again for this final game.
Pero kukunin naman nila yung show nila. Oh. Their show wasn't that, sabi na successful into game number 1, but right now, game number 2, they're feeling it. Game number 3, they're really feeling it. And they just want to pick their comfort heroes. Yes. Na kapag ginagawa nila yan, it is 100% going to be favorable on their side and nasa kanila pa yung momentum as well.
Yes, and still, they're hovering up the mashup deck again right here. At ayan na nga.
Ayaw talaga magpaawat nito.
Oh, yes, naban kasi. Naban kasi.
Yun ang ngiti yan.
Kupra. Sala yung umingit eh, parang iba.
Kupra. Oy, diba? Oh, tayo ang revenge. Sumamba na tayo ang revenge.
Tumacharge.
Ito yung maganda kasi kay Kaplisha. Tinanong siya kung bakit niya ginagawa yung mga bagay na ganyan. Sabi niya, trip niya lang. Hindi, joke lang. Hindi. Ito yung sinasabi niya. Bawat oras na tumatapak ako sa may upuan na yan, or di naman tumatapak sa upuan kasi madumi yun. Umuupo sa upuan na yan at naglalaro ako sa harapan ng mga tao at sa stage. Nagko-compete ako. Masaya ako.
Selena.
Very, ano naman, neto ni Kuya Maraflisha. But again,
go. Masaya ako.
Pero syempre, so Execution Punishers, serious mode muna tayo. Medyo may happy-happy din sa kanan. Tignan naman natin kung ano nga ba ang kalalabasan ng ating larong ito because they locked up already the Masha and finally the Kari. So, woo, very nakaka-intense naman, Grey Water.
Tignan mo sa hate dito, nakikipag-appear na.
Okay, appear lang tayo.
Both teams got what they want. Game number 3. Who will win this series? Who will get the points? Right now, tatandaan natin, nasa 4 points ang Brent.
Yes, Brent, ang pagkakaalala ko. Kasi naka 2-0
na. And if they can get this, then that means pantay sila ng PSO.
Yes, okay. Yes they can. So let's see.
And syempre, naalala natin dito na nagsisimula pala yung tournament natin. That means in terms of points, kailangan ilagay mo na yung
let it all out.
Get the wins, kumbaga. Yes. But the thing is, for Execration Punishers, they really want to put themselves back onto the top.
Oh, and back onto the top indeed, because ladies and gents, we are on to our final game of the day between Brenny Pro and Two Execration Punishers.
For the side dito mga kaibigan ng BRE, it's going to be Fuzaken on the Grok, right? So we'll be playing the Masha, Raphnesia, as the Kaja, Doc Rebo will be playing Carrie and JP with the Lunox.
For the side of Sue Execution Punishers, we have Mei for the Selena Lord, going for the X-Borg, and Max for the Thames, and Ian for the Rafaela, and finally, Hate for that Chu, and mukhang magkakaroon tayo na early team fight dito, ladies and gents. The arrow will not connect, and we see JP here on a low break of health. Let's see, masasave ba siya for the first, oh, looky here, that Selena gets that first blood with the help of Hate, actually aiding other members of Punishers.
And Eto Maxito will just use the flicker to get away. He knows that he could go for that invade kung gugustuhin niya, just because there were a lot of sabihin natin commit onto that top lane.
Yes, indeed. And of course, checking here of Leisha and Doc Rebo pa prioritize right from Crab Take here. And Eto Max, tamang tingin lang and hopes na makuha niya pero syempre hindi niya maagaw. And again, mostly for all pro teams here, talagang priority nila is always the resources with that gold and XP. Syempre ba, paano ka nga naman makakapag-engage ng T5 kapag wala ka nga ng mga ano.
Ako si JP dito, kamuntikan siya mahuli. Isang panaka lang.
Isang panaka lang. Yes, isang arrow ka lang. At ayan na nga nakikita natin dito si JP. Tamang tower hug lang dahil tatlong members ng Punishers ay nasa middle.
Okay. But right now, we are just seeing Execute Punishers and Brent E Pro. They're just rotating around the map, trying to get a pick off. And yun na talaga yung trabaho ng isang Selene.
Yes.
Kumbaga magbigay ng pressure sa mga kalaban mo na iisipin nila, op ka, munti ka siya tamaan doon. Iisipin nga lang nila na laging merong arrow na pwede tumama sa kanila kapag ka walang Selena sa mapa na nakikita.
True. And then it's like a very good... This is also to test kung paano ka ka-alert sa ating battlefield right here. And of course, we are seeing that Brady Pro will be taking that first turtle. Although, tinry ng Punishers na i-face check and invisible yung turtle nun. They weren't able to contest it na kasi too late na eh. I mean, there are more members of Brady Pro there. So if you contest it, it's very risky.
And if you think about it, right now, nahuli si Rensho dito sa may taas and Rensho dito gets the immunity but Rensho still wants to fight. Oui. Rensho will get out. Kuzakin dito with a rival and what a play coming on from BRE. Heads up yon na hindi kayo pwede kumuha masyado ng mga kills na ganyan just because we are ready to fight.
True, and that was a very timely arrival for Kuzaken over there. Kasi kung di siya pa siya dumating, baka mapipick up si ating Mamasha doon. But again, Lord, you're moving on to tower dive na sila anytime soon. And we have Ruff to be killed by the members of Punishers here. But in exchange, ang bottom turret naman siya.
Natandaan mo, there is only an arrival, no departure.
Oh, no.
Pero right now, eto Max, on to the bottom lane.
Aeroplano?
Pero, bakit? I mean, ano bang may arrival? Ano may arrival? Ano may departure? Tama naman.
Tama ka naman. But then, going back to the game, we are seeing Hate here just trying to poke away Renzo right there. Pero syempre, nakikita natin na nag-3-man na ang Red E-Pro. So, sila din. Hindi lang naman ang Punishers ang may kaya magsama-sama tayo.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Ang Red E-Pro, kayang-kaya din.
I agree with that. Now that I'm seeing it, tama ka nga. Like, seriously, kahit tatlo lang sila magsama, okay lang eh. Kasi Grok, Kaja,
and Lunok.
Then Lunok. Ang taas na damage output ayun, si Pusakin, ako po!
Ooh.
Shake! Na-shaken! Crossover!
Misdirection!
Misdirection, shake and bake, lahat binato. Pero oh, JP dito, si JP, hindi mo mamimisdirect yan.
Oh,
hindi mo mamisdirect, they will still get that kill. Pero Punishers, they're not converting these aggressions coming up from BRE into an objective.
And this could be another potential pickup. The Divine Judgment will be used to stop away Samus from getting away. And again, Doc Hugo will be taking that kill.
Ayun, natingnan mo kung ano nangyayari sa Punishers. Doon sa may baba, may na-pick off. Doon sa may taas, may na-pick off. Ang nagawa lang nila, nandun lang sila sa mid, paikot-ikot lang sila. Iniisip nila kung saan sila dapat mag-rotate.
Hindi mapirme kasi. Hindi nila malaman kung saan ba talaga sila mag-respond.
Sa sobrang hindi sila mapirme, hindi sila, napirme sila. Ganun.
So, yung tipong hindi dapat magpanic pero nakapagpanic ng dahil sa hindi.
Tama naman.
Okay, pero going back again, the turtle was in the hands of Brent Epro once more again. Crucial yun because objectives is the key. Geo and Hate are nag-rally doon. Patatamaan ang arrow. Pero up to what cost? Ooh, look at that damage coming from the Selena over there. Flicker and kill. But again, nang dahil sa overextend niya doon, kaya cost her life.
This is not the best place for the side of the Punishers. There are two factors to look at. Number one, you do not have the late game. Losing a Selena will just take your game, extend your game, delay your game plan, and dun kayo magkakaroon ng problema in the late game.
Yes.
Number two, si Renzo dito, sometimes for the offlanes, it's better to just let them go back rather than just go and take them down.
Truly. At gaya nga nasabi mo, no, nade danger zone na ang Punishers dito dahil mahirap na ang magiging playstyle ng Selena when it comes to the mid and early and late phases ng ating game. So they have to move fast.
Yeah.
They gotta be fast. And of course, Wuzaken here stealing that buff away from Sua Execution Punishers, limiting the resources na dapat mapupunta sa kanila.
And right now, nahuli si Expert dito. And then look at that play. Whoop, figure out.
Okay, it was a very good Divine Judgment for the Kaja. Pero na-timing din ang pag-flicker neto ni Tams kanina. Just in time para makatakas siya doon. And of course, Doc Evo here just throwing away minions as usual para din nandun yung pressure na nakakapag-split push ang Brent.
Time is not on their side. Punishers dito, they need to make something happen. Their lineup is good. Kaya nilang mag-takedown. May is a good Selena player. Alam natin yan. He's the only one who plays that in the offlane.
Yes.
Sa mga pro games.
But looking here, the momentum is on the side of Brent Epro. They're taking the map control. At then, Doc Repo was hit by the arrow, but hindi nakapag-retaliate agad simply because there are more members of Brent. Na pagka pinasok na yun, it's going to be very risky. Kuzaken here just going back and Lord just poking him out and going for that
big
Divine Judgment though for that catch and the Lunox with the free hit goes with a casualty.
And Lord dito with the ceiling pan technique.
Ceiling pan technique na maapoy-apoy na hindi lumalabit.
Oh, ceiling pan. Kuya. I mean, una, bentilador lang siya. Kapag kayo, ano, yung steaks, fire steaks. Kapag umigo na siya na lang yung sanity niya, siling
pa. Siling pa na. Pero mainit yung buka.
Mainit yung buka.
Pero again, it is a good objective take as they have another middle lane turret
arrival.
There is an
arrival.
Will be used by the Grok here para makapag-rest po siya. And Doc Rebo will be free-hitting Hate.
Oh.
Hate flickers away, but not in time as Grok goes for the first kill. And Lunox, behind the scenes, nakakuha pa na pick up para sa kanya.
And nakita mo naman yung sinabi doon ni ano? Ni nee. Masha? Ra!
Ra!
But it still is going to be very hard for the side of Bren Ipro to actually end this. Pero I spoke too soon, mga kaibigan. Ectomax dito gets caught out. Goodness gracious, what can Punish the Punishers do?
A good strategy for Bren Ipro here, picking off the members of the Punishers one by one. And walang natamaan ang arrow. And this is, of course, they will be taking that turret first para walang sagabas. Brilliance will be used by the Lunox para hindi siya ma-free hit. And again, goes back having that patience para to potentially hit that way.
Pero Doc Rebo dito, pwede nilang makita si Hate. Na nandyan sa may gilid, Doc Rebo, if he gets caught out here, nag-recall back, and another pick-up on the Selena, and that means libre na naman yung siege nila sa may bottom or top lane.
A very good divine judgment once more for the replay shot. Uy, natipa si Doc Rebo doon, but what did, he did not pursue that way of the dragon kasi alam niyang nandun yung mga other members ng Bren Ipro to aid
Lord resurrecting
over
soon.
There. At syempre, I like the way that Bren Ipro is very patient. Hindi sila nagmamadali mag-push because they know they have that slow scaling potential. But looky here, two members ng Bren Ipro ay naipin dito sa ating apat ng members ng SXP. But again, eto na, having that low break effect, Brilliance will be used once more to add like a chill damage and to actually go away from potential pickups. Oh, look at that! Kills
assault! Hate.
Magagamit! And will be picked off by that Lunox right there. Minus 1 na naman muli! Minus 2 na naman pala for the side of Punishers here! Minus 2 na sa members nila, but the thumbs in exchange. Mamamatay si Masha doon, but up to what cost? Again, nandito tayo sa base. Exposed na for members still. For the side of Breaking from Divine the Judgment! Here para mapatay si Mei. And again, double kill with the free hit of Doc Rebo. And this will be the verdict as Bren Ipro takes game number 3.
Disabog yung ceiling.